There's nowhere else on Earth quite like Antarctica. Our planet's southernmost continent is a land of extremes and a place of incredible natural beauty. But there's also a cutting sense of dread that increasingly runs alongside all the visuals of these spectacular icy landscapes. And so often when we contemplate the future of Earth, we end up considering Antarctica as a see-all gauge for what's going wrong. So, this is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, why are scientists growing worried about the Doomsday Glacier? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. It can feel as though doomsday predictions are difficult to escape nowadays. Scroll through the news or switch on a movie, and it's all there. Wherever you look, it seems that the end of the world is nigh in one way or another. But every so often, a story or a case study comes along with a little more meat to its bones than just your regular panic piece about how life on Earth is limping to a close. In early 2022, for example, there's one prospect, one mass, that's on the minds of many concerned scientists: the Doomsday Glacier. The Doomsday Glacier does also go by a slightly less ominous name, Thwaites Glacier. But really, that's as far as we can go in terms of turning down the bad news when it comes to this particular hunk of ice. Located in West Antarctica, in what's variously described as one of the most remote places on Earth, Thwaites Glacier is a giant of its kind. But it's getting smaller, and that's the problem. Currently coming in at roughly the size of Florida, it consists of the ice sheet on land and the ice shelf floating off land, as most glaciers do. It loses about 50 billion tons of ice every year, though, shedding it into the surrounding water, which in turn accounts for around 4% of the total global sea rise, according to the British Antarctic Survey. In terms of individual contribution, few glaciers offer anywhere near as much as the Thwaites does to the current rising sea levels. Perhaps that's reason enough for scientists to be honing in on Thwaites and trying their best to understand it. But really, it's feared that there still could be bigger problems ahead. It's been estimated that if the entire Thwaites shelf were to melt, then sea levels could rise by at least 2 feet all around the world. This would bring long-lasting devastation to so many coastal towns, major cities, and communities. But more than even that, because Thwaites is such a large glacier at present, it also exerts a major physical influence along the remaining West Antarctic coast. And so scientists are also worried that if it were to break away, disintegrate, or disappear, then it could have knock-on effects for the rest of the surrounding ice, triggering a fast-moving chain reaction wherein yet more of Antarctica melts to water, and therefore the sea levels rise even more severely. Fueled by these mounting concerns, a team of 32 scientists set out for Thwaites in January of 2022 in search of answers. Their two-month mission is part of the International Thwaites Glacier Collaboration, which is a five-year, $50 million joint initiative between the USA and the UK, aiming to better understand the ice, as well as the 32 on board the icebreaker ship, the Nathaniel B. Palmer. There are countless others in offices all over the world ready to process streams of incoming data. Much of that data will be provided by two state-of-the-art robot probes, though, including one from Sweden's University of Gothenburg and another from the UK, famously named Bodie McBoatface, following a brief and pretty hilarious internet naming poll back in 2016. Now, though, Bodie's mission is clearly a much more serious matter. The robot probes will most significantly be deployed beneath the Thwaites ice shelf, as the team study the underside of the glacier first and foremost. Here is where some of the most concerning action is taking place, as steady sea temperature increases have meant that Thwaites is not just shedding from its sides, but is also melting from below. It's known that the underside of Thwaites is by no means as smooth and complete as the glacier's top side can seem. Walk across the top surface of it, and you'd be forgiven for thinking that this was just one massive but well-rounded and predictable mass of ice. But no, instead, on the bottom, Thwaites is marked and scarred with long-running cracks and ever-deepening crevices. Given the warming and subsequent melting that's happening from below then, scientists fear that the cracks and crevices and widening cavities mean that the entire glacier is growing weak. Regardless of how strong and permanent it might look when viewed from above, the future of Thwaites is uncertain. There are some parts of it that are of particular concern, especially along meeting points between the glacier and land, or the glacier and the seabed. Ordinarily, these locations should be strong and reliable, but right now they appear to be brittle. And so it could be that they soon fail, which could then cut huge sections of the glacier adrift, to split a once unbreakable mass into a far more vulnerable collection of crumbling islands. In this way, it might be argued that an in-depth study of Thwaites can double up to serve predictions for the entirety of the Antarctic continent. Because after all, Thwaites is by no means the only glacier that contemporary scientists are worried about. Another of great concern is the nearby Pine Island Glacier, which can be found close to Thwaites in Antarctica's Pine Island Bay in the Amundsen Sea. The Pine Island Glacier is the fastest melting glacier on the continent. It's lost many miles worth of itself since around the 1940s. But what's even more sobering is that the breakup of this bulk of ice has actually been accelerating over recent years and decades in the 21st century. The situation for Pine Island, then, is getting worse and worse at a quickening rate. Were it fully to collapse, it's been estimated that there'd be at least another 1.5 feet of global sea rise to contend with. If Pine Island and Thwaites go, then, as some projections suggest, we're looking at sea levels increasing by upwards of 3.5 feet. And again, that's quite possibly the best-case scenario. As scientists continue to debate the wider impact that a major glacier breakaway could have on the rest of Antarctica's surrounding ice. If a major chain reaction is also triggered, then the results could become less predictable. But seawaters will rise further still. In the modern age of science and technology, the exploration of Earth perhaps doesn't always generate the buzz or attention that it once did. Thanks to past work by various, now iconic explorers, there are so few places on this planet left to discover for the first time. It should be natural, then, that we should have set our sights further afield in search for new frontiers, which is why our efforts toward space travel tend to dominate headlines today. But missions like this latest one, to the southernmost depths of our world, serve as a stark reminder that we've still got a lot of work to do before we can truly understand just the place we're living in right now. The concern and mystery surrounding Thwaites Glacier in particular has led a determined team to journey into the ice in a bid to better our knowledge. Modern technology means that we can now send robots to the heart of the problem, to the dark underside of that ice, to investigate how and why it's disintegrating, and to generate a better informed prediction as to how long we've got left until it's gone. In early 2022, at the time of this mission's start, it said that we could have just 3 to 5 years before the Thwaites ice shelf, at least, is no more. Before it's cast off into the ocean and the knock-on effects are witnessed along coastlines and flatlands all over the world map. The unfortunate truth is that this mission to study it can do nothing to slow or stop the changes in Antarctica from happening. That task is a global one. But in the meantime, science can at least paint a better and more accurate picture for the watching world to make sense of. Because if we hadn't heard of Thwaites Glacier before, we may well hear much more about it in the coming years, and for no good reason. And that's why scientists are growing worried about the Doomsday Glacier. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.